Hello Gundam fans, this is Prime92, and today I'll be looking at the 1/160 scale perfect grade Char Zaku 2 from the original Mobile Suit Gundam series. So this kit is very old. Well, in terms of Gunpla, it came out in... Actually, if you look at my catalog here, with Gunpla from 1980 to 2004, and go to the rather small perfect grades. It's still not that big of a section, even today. If you go to it, you can see the perfect grade Char Zaku came out in July of 1999. Two more years, it'll be 20 years old. And even though it looks like the third kit that came out, it's actually the fourth, because the first perfect grade was actually the AV Unit 1 from Evangelion, which is weird, considering every other perfect grade has been from Gundam, but the first one wasn't even, like, in the same series. Kinda weird. But this is their attempt at an enemy mobile suit. I mean, first it was the RX-72, then the Green Zaku, then the Char Zaku. So, it looks pretty good. Proportions are very good, I think. Colors look good. Detail is... There is detail, but it's more sparse. It's more like, I guess, anime accurate, sort of. The hosing, these are springs, you can see there. So, it's like the original Master Grades, that's I think what they use for springs. Which, it's alright, it does come out a little too easily sometimes. Some parts, they just don't like the hold. The head's noticeable for that too. But, it looks nice. Now the head, let's look at that. Get him down to our level. And drop his backpack cover. But, the head looks pretty good. You got a clear plate over the eye. And the sticker there is kind of yucky looking. It's one of those stickers where if you don't put it on the first time, and you pull it off, you're gonna, like, wreck it. And I kind of wrecked it. I do have a very big sticker sheet here. All stickers, no water slide, no rope transfer. A little disappointing, but once again, one of the first perfect grades, I kind of forgive that. And you do have some chrome in like the pistons here on the shoulder, and the torso. You got some in the knees, and some in like the elbows. It's hard to see, but they're right there. Right there. Lots of screws in the kit, mostly like in the joints, you can see there. So there's dark ones, there's also silver ones. You have to put screws at the ends of where the springs are, so they don't, like, pop out. Mostly just to keep everything nice and tight. I mean, you could try it without it, but I wouldn't recommend it without screws. There are some early Master Grades that are the same way. And then we got his, backpack. And you see the backpack's actually a shade of red. Which I think is accurate. I never really paid attention to his backpack. There's some more chrome in there. The hydraulic with the... Okay, the thing that the early perfect grades were trying to do were showing the inner detail. So there were panels that were designed to pop out. Like this one here. You've got a hydraulic. And then a piece here pegged in. So you are supposed to be able to connect them together. It's a little port in there. And then they would come out and rest up there. This was not the best. It does help it stay together when you pick it up here and it's closed. But resting doesn't really... It's not the best. But there are other ports and stuff. Like on the head, you have an opening panel here. Show some inner detail. Let me think. The torso. The torso is kind of a pain in the butt to do. But basically... There are panels on the sides here that you can actually pull out. They have a double hinge. And I'm worried that it's going to unlodge the head, because the head is actually not connected that well to the torso, unfortunately. It's literally connected by, like, from what I can tell, two thin pegs that go underneath the maroon armor right here where the arm is. So I'm trying to get these out of the way, but you can raise them up. And then there's some... Oops. There's some inner detail there. Get the light on it. You can see that. The chest panel comes down too, but it's kind of annoying to try to get. But the thing is, there's nothing there, if you look. There's no inner frame in the chest, like, it's only on the sides. And you got a Char in there. There is a pilot, which is good. And you can move him over. There's actually a... the chair is movable. You can move from one, like, left or right. And there's a panel here, like a display panel. But it's very sparse in here. I was kind of disappointed that there was no complete inner frame in the torso. Now, the RX-52 is the same way, but the thing is, it has the core fighter, so it gets away with having a hollow torso because it needs a core fighter in there. But I was really surprised that this one had it. But once again, very early perfect grade. I can forgive for that. They're trying to figure out what to do. Other panels, you've got panels on the legs here. You can open up, and you can see the extra detail in the leg. The thrusters, and you just push it back in. A little sliding track up here. Piston in here, in his bum, so you can actually do that. I don't really know what this does. I don't think it does anything, because it doesn't really help with any articulation. Same thing here. You can move this part up and down. Well, it usually works. There you go. You can do that. Hooray. I mean, I guess that helps some with some poses, I suppose, but you can also do this. And you can have him flash the camera. And there's some more hot pistons in there, you can see. So when he does that. Yeah, okay. It's different. It is different. A little gimmicky on the program, which is fine. Now, the eyes do have an LED. I didn't put them in. Just one LED for the mono eye. But basically, everything would feed into the collar here, which I guess is why it's not that secure into the torso, so you can pull it out easily. Put the two, those little round batteries in there, and then you just flip the switch just in the, right here, the chest, like when you pull the chest panel down. It's a little switch, and we turn the eye on. But you have to actually, like, manually put the wires in, and all the little pieces, and I don't like doing that stuff, so I didn't, because I'd only do it one time. And on the camera. And that'd be it. So, it does look pretty awesome. I do like how it looks. I am happy with how it looks as a perfect grade. It looks good. I put it on the shelf. It looks good with the other perfect grades, I think. Some of the design with the opening panels is gimmicky. And it doesn't really do much for the kit. But it was interesting at the time. I thought it was interesting when I got the original master grade. And it did that. I'm like, holy crap. Well, the only thing I don't like is that, like I said, the chest is kind of hollow. But everything else does have an inner frame, so I can kind of forgive it when they're trying to do some stuff up there. Now, the head can rotate side to side, can go up and down. It'd be nice if I had it on the camera so you can actually see. There we go. And there is a little switch at the back of the head. Right there. And you can rotate the mono eye. And I really like it here because it's so big you can easily see it without a problem. Huh? What'd you say to me? What? I like it. And then the arms can go forward and back. And up, and now you can see the piston working. Now, I actually have to confess, I had to glue this bottom piece here, right there. It sandwiches the actual connection where the hydraulic is. There's one here and one up there, and it plays into the torso. And if I didn't do that, it would just pull right out, and I was worried that eventually having to fit it back in every single time, it would break here somewhere, so I just super glued that piece in. So that's kind of annoying, but I had to do it. The shoulder armor here is on a hinge, and the arms can rotate forwards and back. They can go out here as well, at the actual shoulder, so you get about that far out altogether. Rotate the shoulder. You do have a double-jointed elbow. You've got a hinge in the wrist. The hand is kind of more of a swivel than like a ball joint, but it can go out, not so much in. And you do have the fully posable fingers, which I do like. These ones are pretty good. I don't have any problem with them wanting to come apart. They're very solid. Then you have the waste, which can... Oh! You can do that. Yeah, see, these things are solid, like, or hollow. Or, like, newer ones, you'd have, like, inner frame panels in there, probably. But you can rotate some. And you can get some ab crunch, which I guess is why this piece moves. To allow you to do that. And then put it back down if you want to have it look a little more solid in there. Skirt armor is hinged. Up there, it's really interesting how it works, because it gets right out of the way. Really like what they did there. And then you have the side skirt, which does that much, really. Legs will go forward. And yeah, the basket can move a little. And they'll go back that far. And go out almost all the way to the side. They'll rotate at the hip. And they have a double joint to me. And you got all that piston action. Very nice. Chrome. I don't like it a lot. And actually, I really like how this part works. If you watch this. How it bends. It's hard to see. You can actually move this out of the way, too. And you can actually see how that hydraulic bends. I really like that. And that's probably why this moves, so you can see it. And then the angle. There's another piston. I forgot about this part. You can actually lift up, too. So you can see the piston working. All these parts are to show the inner workings of the kit, really. So you have forward and back, and forward and back. And then there's some side to side, and a little bit of rotation. And then the toe action here. Now this is really weird, because this is completely hollow. Another thing with earlier kits. But yeah, there's nothing in here. It felt really weird putting it together, because it's just one big hollow piece. Well, two pieces. But it's super hollow. So it's kind of weird. Kind of weird. And the part here, the top part, the pink part of the foot, doesn't really peg that well into place. It just kind of rests in place. It's a strange arrangement. And then you have the thrusters, which can move up and down, so... Yeah, that's about it. So it's actually got decent articulation. Everything, aside from the feet being weird, they still can move, and you can get some good poses, and it's still... the arm was the only problem I had with it, and it is a little scary when it didn't want to stay together. It kept pulling itself apart when I moved it. But since I glued it, it is fine. So articulation, for being almost 20 years old, is pretty good. So you can, if you want, make it into a normal mass production kind of suit with the flat head instead of the command antenna. But I don't use that. But you can if you want. I guess it's what came with the original. You've also got the Heat Hawk, which I love the fact that it's purple. I really like that. You got the clear blade piece. It looks pretty nice. And you have a mounting unit to put onto the side skirt. This thing. It's really weird to have like a separate piece. But it essentially will clip in here. See if I can remember how to do this. Oh, yeah, right here. Clips like that, and then kind of raise it up so it kind of rests against... Right there. Rests against this part of the axe. And now you can peg it into polycat just sitting out in the open. It's kind of weird. Right there on the side skirt. A weird hexagonal-shaped polycat just sitting there. It's on both sides. You can do that. Or, you do have a little tab here, which is a pain in the back skirt to get out, so I'm gonna use my hobby knife with the help of KOG. There we go. So you got a little peg on a ball joint. And you do have a little teeny baby tab on the bottom of the palm. So you can tab it. And this is probably the most secure hold, like, securely held Heat Hawk on any Zaku model I have. Because of that tab. Yeah. It looks so weird being purple, though. Like, with the rest of the kit. It's very strange. But it works. It works. And then you have the machine gun. Which, it does look nice. It has all the... Like, it's pretty much one color. You have a clear piece here for the scope, which can move all the way down. This extra handle can move. It looks like this part here should move, but it's just molded into it. And there is some text now that I look at it on the Zionic caliber 120mm. Wow. That's cool. I didn't even notice that before. This part can come off, and I'm going to try and pry this open because it's really secure, but it's really neat that you actually have the ammo in here. Oh, where'd you go? Well, it kind of flew apart, but you actually have all the bullets fitting into the drum here, which is kind of neat. And I think there's actually a certain way they peg. Yeah, there's a little peg there. They have to peg in right in the front, like that. And the weird thing is, they actually give you a single bullet by itself. Really strange. I don't know where to put it. It doesn't say where to put it, but it's a single bullet. It's going to get lost. But you can actually see them, which I don't think we've ever, like, they don't do that anymore, so it is neat to have one. Like, that actually shows you the ammo individually. So, that's neat. I think it's neat. And it just pegs right there. Also, I don't know what that does. It's another peg, but I don't think it does anything. And you do have another little tab, which is a lot easier to get out. Right there. So, unfortunately, these are both right-handed. You can't use them on the left hand, which is a little annoying. So let's try and get this in his hand. Even though it is easy to get out, it is easy to fall back in to the gun. So, yeah, and they have a hole here so that the trigger part's not entirely covered. So you just put the hand right in there without having to feed it through the hole. And that is about it. Yep, there we go. It's not as secure as the Heat Hawk, I find, but it is there. And it will stay there for the most part. And I just put this back over here. Maybe. Come on there. There we go. And all of his accessories, the two of them, can be on the suit. Although, I guess we can look at the shield. It does rotate, I guess, out of the way, and it does have the hydraulic there, so it can move up and down, and up and down, up and down. Yeah, and I should mention, he does have a working cockpit in the chest. Oops, I keep hitting the camera. But it does go up, right there. I'm not going to put it all the way up because there's really nowhere to get your fingernail and get it down if you go all the way up. There's a little indent here you can use right now, but if you put it all the way up, you can't get it down. I had to use my hobby knife to, like, scratch it down. So, a little, weird that there's a little tab or anything, but I mean, I guess you could pull the whole chest down and pull it down, but that's kind of weird. So, yeah. Those are the accessories. Very few, but you know what? That's what the Zaku 2 had, and it's pretty good. I really like the font on the machine gun. It's kind of cool. So, let's do some comparisons. Because why not? So, got the Zaku 2 here. I'm gonna reach on my shelf and bring down the dusty RX-78-2. Yeah, like I said, his gun doesn't hold the best, I find. So you can just get rid of that for now. But yeah. Got them both together. Pretty cool, actually, having them both in the same time. I like it. They're actually going to be standing side by side on the shelf. And then, not another perfect grade, but because I can grab them, because I made them easy to grab, the 160 scale Exia. So you can see a kit that is, like, 10 years, made 10 years after, pretty much. Over 10 years, actually, because he came out in 2007 or 2008. Can't remember. So, yeah, about 10 years. Almost 10 years. So, yeah. That is the perfect gray Char Zaku 2. I do like it. It does have some problems, basically because it's old. Mostly the fact that the torso doesn't seem to have, like, a complete inner frame does bother me. Also, the fact that a lot of the panels that open up and stuff, sometimes they don't hold that well, especially the backpack. Backpack's the worst. And the feet are a little weird. Once, like I said, they're kind of hollow on the bottom, and they don't really set together that well. But it's, and of course the shoulder part there I had a problem with, but it's pretty solid, all things considered. And it does look really good, and it does have good articulation. And the accessories it has, which, strangely colored, but other than that, it is a pretty solid kit. But don't expect anything super amazing from it, because it is, like I said, almost 20 years old, so you gotta just take this guy with a grain of salt if you build any of the newer ones. So that is about it, and I'll see you in the next review.